When you heard Dr. Mandell was going to retire, how did you think he would spend his time?
He said, well, I'm going to do a little fly fishing. I'm definitely going to become an expert at scuba diving. And we bought a little place in Florida, so by the way, it's on the West Coast.
I had absolutely the right solution for Jim. It was sail, be with his grandchildren that he absolutely adores, and take Val shopping.
So what did Dr. Mandell actually end up doing?
First thing in the morning, he goes swimming, and he's, you know, like 6 in the morning. And I said, yeah, and then what do you do? And he said, well, I've got to go do my rounds. Then what do you do? He said, well, I'm having lunch with somebody, and then I'm going over to Franciscan for a meeting this afternoon. And then, you know, they're honoring somebody that you know because I think you're going to be there this evening. And he said, so I'll go to the dinner this evening. I said, well, I'm glad you have the day off.
Work ethic aside, what makes Jim Mandell a great caregiver and leader?
Jim cares about either the people of an organization or an effort. He cares about the institution or the company. And it's not about Jim. He's always been, how do I leave something better than I found it? How do I have impact? And how do I just give 100% of myself?
When I first met Jim Mandell, it was probably during one of the most difficult times of my life. My wife and I had just found out that we were going to have a child with cystic fibrosis. I've never met a doctor in my entire life that has the bedside manners and the compassion that Jim Mandell has. And I've learned from Dr. Mandell what it's like to be a good dad, how to cope with adversity. And he would always give you that encouragement and that hope to continue on. And he made you feel that everything was going to be all right.
But Dr. Mandell also knows when to convey his famous sense of humor, demonstrated in this video for a live audience fundraiser.
Okay, you have a 9 o'clock with the chief of surgery. At 10, you have to meet with the bozos in the clown care unit. At 11, it's Paw Prints. They've been dogging us for weeks. After that, you've got 15 minutes for sandwich, wheat bread, no mayonnaise. At 2, meet with PR. You have a 3 with Childlife. And at 4, they want you at the cart to check out some exciting new research. Zebrafish. Very cool. Oh, and on the way home, remember to stop for some low-fat milk. All right, Mandell, it's time to talk budget.
He can give it, and he can take it.
He's changed his whole personality because he's gone incognito. The first thing he did is shaved his mustache. He went and got a new hairstylist so that he could look a little different.
But it's Dr. Mandell's compassion, leadership, and knowledge that makes Franciscan Hospital for Children grateful to have him by their side.
So Jim is extremely well known in the children's healthcare community, both in Boston, but also nationally and internationally. And the ability for Jim to take our message and bring that to other venues is extremely important to us.
Jim has unbelievable compassion, and compassion for, in Franciscan's case, children who really have a really long road to hoe, families who are in desperate need of support and help, and Jim will put all of that together for the good of both the institution, but also the patients and family that the institution serves.
Dr. Mandell is being honored for his contributions to children's hospitals here and around the world. And Franciscan Hospital for Children could not ask for a better advocate.
Franciscan's is the place that does the kind of work that is so focused on improving children's lives and helping families cope with complex disease that without it, the families and the patients that come here would be an impossible situation. And when you have that kind of resource, it's so vital, we need to figure out a way to make sure that it's strong, that it's lasting, and that it gets the kind of recognition that it needs.